I'm Doug Hughes. I'm 61 years old, and I'm a mailman working out of Riverview, Florida. No sane person would do what I'm doing. I have carefully planned it so that nobody will get hurt, including me, especially me. I'm not suicidal, and I'm not going to commit suicide, and I'm not going to fly into any monuments. Terrorists don't announce their flights before they take off, okay? Terrorists don't broadcast their flight path. Terrorists don't invite an escort to go along with them. I have got a plane, a gyroplane, and I'm going to fly it. I'm going to violate the no-fly zone nonviolently. I intend for nobody to get hurt. And I'm going to land on the Capitol Mall in front of the Capitol building. I'm going to have 535 letters strapped to the landing gear in boxes. And those letters are going to be addressed to every member of Congress. I'm delivering the message right to them, not for their sake, but for the impact that it will have, because I'm trying to galvanize millions of people to do a relatively simple thing. Change the government to build a wall of separation between the government and big money so that government will represent the people. There are these problems and these problems and these problems that are much more important than campaign finance reform. But those won't get addressed until we fix campaign finance reform. I don't believe that the authorities are going to shoot down a 60-year-old mailman in a flying bicycle. I'm going to give them plenty of warning, well over an hour in advance of me getting to the no-fly zone, so that they know who I am and what I'm doing, and that it's intended to be nonviolent. I'm defenseless. They could knock me down. A Boy Scout with a BB gun could shoot me down. But I don't believe that anybody wants to personally take responsibility for the fallout that would result from publicly executing somebody for an act of dissent. I have thought about walking away from this whole thing because it's crazy. And I have thought about being 75 years old and watching the collapse of this country and thinking that I had an idea that might have arrested the fall. And I didn't do it. And I will tell you completely honestly, I'd rather die in the flight than live to be 80 years old and see this country fall.